The relation between Putin and that oligarch class is actually kind of complicated, right? It's neither true that he completely controls them nor that he is their puppet, right? It's a
Correct.
More convoluted
it's
thing.
It's more
than
like
that.
A kind of mafia state, is yeah. I think the way some people have put it. And I agree with that. And by the way, early on, Putin got a lot of props for people for seeming to put the oligarchs in their place.
Yes, yes.
The 90s wasn't a pretty picture.
It was awful.
It was awful. And you had a hard time making ends meet or eating. And people said, if this is capitalism, I don't want to have anything to do with it.
Yeah, screw it. Let's go back to the old stuff. Yeah.
So, initially, Putin brought back a sense of order. He was aided in great measure by the fact that oil prices suddenly went through the roof.
Right.
And so suddenly money was pouring into the Russian economy. He needed to show the Russian people from a political perspective that he could take charge of these oligarchs. And he does. He basically boots out two of them, one of whom, a guy named Boris Berezovsky, who had been his big supporter. But he boots out Berezovsky because Berezovsky owns a TV channel. And he boots out another guy named Gusinski because Gusinski owns a TV channel. Now Putin has two of the most powerful TV channels in his pocket. The rest of the oligarchs then didn't disappear. It wasn't like Putin said, we're not going to have rich people anymore.
Yeah.
It's we're just going to have rich people who do what I say.
Right.
And
they had to accommodate themselves.
They had to accommodate themselves to what Putin wanted politically.
Right.
And then they could feel free to do what they wanted, which in its own way is kind of like the Chinese system too. You just don't mess with the Communist Party, then you can be as ruthless and as corrupt as you want to be.